Welcome to SBCU. Let's talk about the trail machine, the Stumpjumper FSR. Stumpjumper has a long history within Specialized, but the idea of the bike, being a bike that climbs and descends equally well, has never changed. One of the most interesting parts about the Stumpy is that it has lots of different options. Now there's 29-inch wheel size, there's smaller wheel sizes, there's standard builds, and then there's Evo builds as well. So plenty to choose from, but it's important to remember to pick the bike based on what your needs are out there. So if you want a trail bike, absolutely perfect pick is the Stumpjumper. If you want to get a little bit more crazy on your trail bike, maybe the Evo is your style. So the difference between the two is a couple of geo changes and a little bit of difference in between how it's actually built out, but the frame platform is the same. So let's talk about some of the features on the frame. Tapered head tube on all the bikes, whether the carbon or aluminum. You have command post routing on the carbon bikes internally down the down tube, or on the non-carbon bikes, you have internal routing along the top here. As you get towards the back of the bike, we do a lot of Fox shocks with brains on their higher end. And then to save a little bit, when you get a little bit more affordable bikes, you'll go to just standard Fox shocks on there. The shock extension onto the shock link here with full cartridge bearings, moving back into the FSR. Now it's important that the FSR be on this bike as with any Specialized bike, but this is a unique FSR. As with all of our experiences, it's built for the experience of the bike. So active and independent, but an FSR that's focused on doing everything, climbing, descending, really a beautiful all around bike. The last thing here is that you notice that this frame does not have a front derailleur on it, but it does have the provisions for putting one on. It's a direct mount derailleur, so very easy to put on, take off, no matter whatever flavor you want to run on your Stumpy. So the geometry on the Stumpjumper is super important. This is, like we said, one of the most all-around capable bikes. It has to climb, it has to descend, it's got to do it all. So that's going to relate a lot to how we put the package together. But there's also, you know, Evos and regular Stumpjumpers, 29 and smaller inch wheel sizes. So the geometry, it has to be long in the top tube, low in the bottom bracket, and nice and tight in the rear end. That's a general idea to give us the handling that we want, but there are some differences. The head tube angle on the standard 29er that we have here is 69 degrees. As you go to an Evo version, that's gonna slack out a little bit. So you get just a little bit longer wheelbase, a little bit more travel, a little bit bigger capability. The bottom bracket height, nice and low on the bike, and it will change just a little bit as you move in between a standard and an Evo. The Evo will drop a little bit along with getting a little bit more travel. And the rear end, very, very short rear end. We want that because it's nice and snappy around the corners, but still gives you some room for those high speed descents, not gonna get all chattery and start freaking out on you. So, you know, good Specialized style of geometry, roomy top tube for a nice fit, low bottom bracket, short rear end, plenty of different options, different wheel sizes and Evo options as well. Another cool feature about the Stumpjumper FSR is that we wanna make sure we have nice low standover height, so it's good for the fit, but it's also good to make sure in case you come off the bike, you're not gonna end up hurting yourself. And we wanna make sure that inside the main triangle that you can fit a full-size water bottle on any size frame so you can carry as much water as you want out there on the trail. Very important that you be able to do those two things. So a lot of what can make a great bike even better are the details on the bike, and the Stumpjumper has that in spades. Up here on the handlebar cockpit area, we have a low slung handlebar. This is what we call a mini rise, 720 millimeters wide. If you go to an Evo, it gets even bigger to 750 millimeters with our SIP grip lock-on grips as well. We have a 130 millimeter travel fork on the 29er, goes to 140 on the Evo version, and even 150 on the Evo of the smaller wheel size. And when you get into the front here, you can see we have nice Fox forks on the standard bikes, pikes on the Evo version, and then the Reval control trail wheels as well. On the S-Works bikes, the SL wheels is super light. That's your carbon rim. Remember that these are very light, but they're also built for durability. These are the trail versions of the wheels, so very, very strong wheels. It's a good blend of lightweight and stiffness. You also notice that you have a lever on your bike there. That's your internally routed command post. New design, nice and slick looking here, but also just a third of the force required to activate the lever than it used to be. And you still have those three travel options all the way at the top, your cruiser position, and all the way down at the bottom. Here in the middle of the bike, one of my favorite shocks of all time is the Specialized Fox Brain and Autosag shock. So all kinds of crazy cool features in here. This shock is built for trail riding, so it has a different tune than, say, a Brain on the Epic. It's the same concept. We want to give the bike more efficiency by limiting how much influence the rider puts into the shock, but still is free to activate when it's hitting the bumps. It just has a lighter tune, a trail tune to that Brain. The Autosag is the same as you'd find on any Specialized bike. Very quick, easy, and correct to set up any rider to make sure that they get the proper sag every single time. Moving to the back of the bike, you see that we have XX1 on this particular bike. You can run single, you can run double if you want to, and you know, no problem to run either different version. And what's really cool thing about the Revol wheel is it's a very easy swap to go from a standard cassette body to, say, an XX1 style. You just go ahead and pop off one driver body, put a new one on, and you're good to go. And one of my last favorite features, super cool, nobody ever seems to notice, but the clip-on chainstay protector. You know, it used to be that when you wanted to keep your bike quiet, you'd go ahead and wrap a tube around there, put some junky Velcro thing on. This is a snap-on version. It's super integrated, goes on there. You'll never notice it at all, but it keeps the bike nice and quiet and also protects your frame if your chain's slapping around. So lots of fantastic features on here. Stumpy, one of the longest running bikes in Specialized history, still one of the most fun.